In this video, I'm going to tell you how to build a portfolio as a newbie developer that will get you hundreds of jobs. Well, something like that. That will get you the job that you want. As a newbie developer, you need to get a portfolio. Really, really important. That's what we're going to be breaking down and talking about in this video. If you're just joining me for the first time, I'm John from simpleprogrammer.com. Like I said, you are on the channel where you can learn soft skills for software developers, where you can learn your career management skills, how to improve your career, how to make more money, how to develop social skills as a developer, how to market yourself, all those type of things. If that sounds like something that's interesting to you, and it should be, because that's how you make the money, all right, click that subscribe button and join us. I think you'll find that the content that we produce here at Simple Programmer is pretty unique. When you're starting out as a developer, one of the best things that you can possibly do in order to get a better job, all right, or to get clients if you're doing freelancing, is to have a portfolio of work. Now, the reason being for having this is because one of the greatest risks that any company has in hiring a developer is they are not sure if you can code. I'm being serious here. I've hired a lot of developers in my time, and I've interviewed a lot of developers, and you'd be surprised at the master's degree computer science students that, you know, with 10 years of experience that I've gotten into an interview, and it was pretty apparent that they couldn't code. When you have a portfolio of your work, as long as I can verify that it's your work, I know that you wrote this. I know that you can code. I know that you can actually do the work. It's the best proof, right? If you're gonna hire an architect, right, to design your house, the best proof that you could have that they make good designs is some building that they designed. I don't understand why so many developers don't understand this, why they think, oh, it's all about interview questions and all this stuff. Yes, you're gonna be interviewed, okay? It's true, all right? But the best way to prove that you know what you're doing and that you're a good developer and to show what kind of code you write and how you write that code, all right, is to just see it. A lot of times, even as a developer, once I built my portfolio, one of the things I would do when I go into interviews is I'd bring my laptop and I'd be like, hey, real quick, you know, before we get into this, or, you know, do you mind, can I just show you my portfolio, some of the projects I've worked on? You know, I turn my laptop and say, and you can look at the code. I just want to give you a really clear idea of what kind of code you can expect from me, what kind of developer I am, and, you know, and what I can do. And a lot of times I've hijacked the entire interview where they had this and they're just looking through my code and just asking me questions about my code. Perfect. Bam. You think I got those job offers? I got job offers for those jobs, those interviews? Yes, of course I did. All right? Because the proof is in the pudding. Let's talk about what you need to do. The first thing is that if you're a web developer, you should have a website. I know, pretty basic, pretty obvious, but you'd be surprised how many web developers I know that don't have a website. Not only should you have a website, it should probably look good. If you're not a designer, that's fine. Hire a designer after you've built your website to go back and improve the design of the website. It's also an important skill to know, because a lot of times for small companies, you might get hired as a developer and you might have to go and hire or work with a web designer to actually design to make things look pretty. I've been a developer on projects before where they're like, okay, make this thing and make it look pretty. And I'm like, I don't know how to make things look pretty. And they're like, well, figure it out. What I've had to do is go and build the thing and then hire someone, okay, as a freelancer to go and make it look pretty. On the webpage, what should you have? Well, you should have projects that you've worked on, that you've created, that you can show the source code for, all right, that demonstrates specifically the technology that you are applying for jobs for. Okay, you need to have some kind of niche, some kind of expertise, all right? What is it that you're gonna do? Let's say that you're an Angular developer. All right, you should have on your portfolio some websites that you've built, okay, where they can go and they can see the website, all right, they can click on it, and then they can download the source code, or they can see the GitHub profile or your GitHub repository where you have the source code for it, all right, and you should document that, right, so they can see all that stuff. And you should have at least 3 projects, right? I'd like to see 5, honestly. Create a company name for yourself, all right? Go register the LLC if you want to or not. You can just do a DBA if you're not really making any money from it. Go take some apps, all right? Put it out there and make it so someone can sign up and so there's a fee. Maybe there's a free version, all right? Do that so it looks commercial, all right? And you can even use in your portfolio some actual commercial apps that you've worked on with other companies. I mean, if you're a newbie developer, you might not have that, but create some simple stuff, right? You know, create something that would be commercially viable, right? Have at least one big project there, and you can have some small stuff that demonstrate your ability to use specific technologies and how you write your code and things like that, all right? But make them look good, all right? We judge based on appearances. Another good option is to put some apps in the app store. I always talk about doing mobile development if you're just starting out. But you can put apps in the app store, and then that's an even better proof, right? If you show, okay, I'm a developer, I say I'm a developer, I know how to write code, and I've got actual apps that I have in the app store that you can find, and you can download this on your phone. Again, that takes you from newbie to like senior level developer right there. Because how many newbie developers can do that, right? So you're gonna be able to apply for better jobs, to be more likely to get those jobs. And like I said, the proof is in the pudding. They could say, oh, you don't have enough experience, but you could say, well, what do you need me to do? Because look, I can create these apps. This is what I'm able to do. This is my skill set. This is what I can actually do. Just come up with some simple ideas. If you're going to come up with a portfolio, let's say you're just going to have 3 apps in your portfolio, all right? First of all, have a website, all right? And make the website very clearly indicate, here's my portfolio, right? Maybe even on the front page, all right? Here's my 3 apps that are in my portfolio, okay? Now, out of those 3, you can make 2 simple ones. Maybe you can make one that's like a to-do list, right? Try to think of something a little more creative. Or maybe something that's like a little email client clone, like a Gmail clone or something like that. It's a little bit more sophisticated. And then have one that's actually like a decent sized project, something that you would potentially commercially sell, something that has, you know, at least a few thousand lines of code. So you can show that you're doing something like, you know, some CRUD application, right? Something that actually uses a database and you can update records, delete them, you know, insert records, right? That shows that you can do kind of the full stack of development. It's worth the time, it's worth the investment to do that. And when you go into interviews, make sure that you highlight those. You know, bring your own laptop and say, hey, look, could you take a look at my portfolio? Or you can use this when someone asks you a question, say, oh, what is polymorphism? You can say, you know what? And you can describe it and you can say, but I've got a real good example of this in this app that I created. In fact, oh, I just happen to have it right here. You pull up your laptop and you're like, see, so in this app, this is where I use polymorphism and this is why I did this. And now they're looking at your portfolio, right? There's a ton of ways that you can do that. Or they could say, oh, you know, describe some kind of problem that you worked on that was really hard, but you solved it. And you can say, well, you know, there was this one app I was creating and it was like this, you know, this Gmail clone, and in it I had this problem, and you describe it, and then you're like, and you know what, actually I can show you, like, here it is, let me just bring this up real quick, and now you're showing them your portfolio. So you want to find a way to bring that up in the interview. It's going to make a big difference. If you haven't already, make sure that you subscribe, and you know, if you're a new developer, also check out the Complete Software Developer Career Guide. If you haven't already, this is my big 800-page book that tells you everything you need to know about becoming a software developer. I'll talk to you next time. Take care.